Si Ambassador Amadagordi, Secretary of Senyo Balisakan, my former boss. He was chair of the PIDS. To our speakers, panelists, moderators, and our guests today, welcome to this conference organized by the ANU and the PIDS, and a pleasant morning to you all. The theme of this two-day conference, Regulation and Governance in the Philippines, Development Policy Challenges for the New Administration, is a familiar topic to all of us. In the immediate past, we have witnessed how good governance can provide a firm foundation for the country's development agenda. We have also learned that regulatory reform is part of any good governance trust for the government. I would not repeat what the Ambassador said about Philippine performance, but I think that the topic chosen for today's conference underpins this recent remarkable Philippine economic growth. Good governance and better regulation had palpable benefits, and the strong macro fundamentals currently enjoyed by the economy testify to them. Today, as the government continues to pursue inclusive growth and poverty reduction, this familiar topic attains a greater importance. There is a large scope for working toward coherence and effectiveness in the country's regulatory policies and institutions, and more importantly, in implementing competition policy, a landmark achievement of the past administration, to uphold consumer welfare and ensure competitive markets. I submit that regulatory reform and effective competition policy correlate well with strategies to achieve inclusive growth and poverty reduction, and indeed, this familiar topic deserves a second, closer look. For its part in all of this, so to speak, the PIDS has done several policy studies on today's conference topic and continues to address issues of regulation and governance. In 2015, the PIDS study entitled Toward an Effective Regulatory Management System highlighted the need to establish an effective regulatory management system in the country. That paper also took a look at the experience of Australia and New Zealand in developing effective regulatory management system. So experiences of those two countries and also Malaysia informed the writing of that paper. I believe there's a copy of the small book on this outside. Is it for sale? Sorry. Where am I? And I'm advertising it because I was the author of the third chapter. In that same year, 2015, PIDS led the celebration of the 13th Development Policy Research Month with the theme Effective Regulations for Sustainable Growth. That study showed that the Philippines has the elements of an effective and functioning regulatory management system, but it has to do more serious work to put them together and make it more formal and effective. More recently, the PIDS has also reviewed the regulations covering the tuna industry, food manufacturing, and the service industries in an attempt to uncover regulations that have to be revoked because they unnecessarily burden firms and only contribute to increasing the cost of doing business in the country. Today's forum, let us welcome and thank our able speakers and panelists, especially our keynote speaker, Secretary Balisakan, who will walk us through critical issues and regulation and governance, and I pray that our collective voice will speak out about what government and society as a whole should do to move forward reform, to move forward reforms in regulation and governance. In closing, please allow me to take this opportunity to thank the Australian government and the Australian National University for co-organizing this forum with us. We at PIDS also look forward to a fruitful research collaboration with the ANU Philippines project that will motivate evidence-based policies and regulations in the country. Again, welcome, thank you, and have a good day.